yes, traders. I hope you're ready. Let's do this. So glad you can't see me right now. Yes, 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 yes. Get ready, traders. Get ready, let's get ready, let's get ready. All right. Do this, let's do this. Oh yes. All right, traders, welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to another masterclass with Oliver Velez. Of course, my name is Oliver Velez. For many of you know me, some of you may not, but today is going to be a very special day. I'm going to share some very, very powerful things. And over the next 2 hours, I'm going to go over specific techniques, specific trading concepts, and give you the ability to handle yourself in any market. Stocks, options, bonds, futures, Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies, any market. Equipped you with all set of tools today, but powerful tools, ability to handle your very professional way. I want you to understand that I have been training traders for the past 26 years of my life. I've been trading the financial markets over the past 38 years. That's crazy. But in all of my 26 years of training traders all over the world, from very professional traders to novices, I found that there are small set of principles that are typically violated that failure. So we're going to talk about the principles that lead to failure. You don't commit those things. You're going to, once again, walk away with some tools that will give you the ability to handle you more professionally. Right now, for the benefit of those who do not know who I am, let me just start off by introducing you. Again, as I mentioned, my name is Oliver Velez. Guys, I placed my first trade in 1980. I became a professional. I remember this day like it was professional on December 6th of 1986. Years after that, I decided to leave Wall Street after having huge success, decided to branch off and actually form my own company called Pursuit. That was in September of 19. Pristine would go on over a 12-year period to become the largest trading and training organization in the entire industry. Barron's, which is an institutional paper trusted by professionals all over the world, Barron's ranked my work number one in America. That was an honor. The Dow Jones, the venerable Dow Jones, company that 100 years, dubbed me the Messiah trading, 1999. When the industry trading got together to begin forming its first convention, first annual convention, it chose me to be the representative of the entire trading community. I was the keynote speaker, the very first traders exposition in the years 1999 and also the best-selling author of 5 trading books written in 5 different. These 5 trading books are designed to teach the average individual to trade the markets. These 5 trading books sell more copies this very day. All other trading books written. Today, I have one of the largest, if not the largest, trading organizations, 10,000 plus equity and forex traders, many of whom trade my I continue to be an advisor for markets, various exchanges. This is a picture of me at the very first International Traders Expo. You can read very carefully here, right? It says Velez is one of the top day traders in the country. That was in 1999. This is the article in Barron's that ranked my work, my company formed in number 1. And here's an image of all of the books written. I mentioned my books are written in 5 different Spanish, Mandarin, German. Before we actually delve into the material, I do want you to know that I strongly encourage you, if markets, if you're trading, I'd love for you to follow me on certain social networks. Instagram, I am probably active on. And my most active following, my most active traders, they follow me. Right? Many also take in my live sessions on Periscope. I have 2 Periscope channels, an English one, OL Velez 007, and a Spanish one. Right? I go live mostly on the Periscope. Of course, you're here at my YouTube. I believe that my YouTube is one of the most valuable channels as it relates to trading. I spend a great deal of time making sure that 365 days, every single day of the year, I provide a valuable content to help you take another step in your. Of course, you can. So, here, I want to talk about what I specifically have every single one of my. I put every single one of my traders through extensive training. And actually, I prefer to get a trader that has very little. I prefer to get a trader that has very little. Guys, am I coming through okay? Hello? Oh, okay. Let me see is it the mic, you think? Oh, okay. Let me try. Guys, give me just a second. I just heard that we're having some technical difficulties with the Give me just a second. Give me just a second, guys. Testing, testing, testing. Testing, testing. How is that? Does that sound better? Am I coming through? Am I coming through, guys? I'm wondering if it's the mic or my internet connection. My internet connection seems to be fine. Testing, testing. Gotta let me know. You gotta let me know. Sounds good now? Better? I didn't really do anything, but... All right. All right, let's see. It's okay, much better now? Okay. Let's hope we're back now. Let's hope we're back now. Okay. Let's hope we're back now. Good. Okay. Juan, I'm going to keep your chat open because I cannot see the chat, okay? So I need you to communicate with me here and let me know if we can have issues. Okay. Guys, what I was saying is that I put every trader through an extensive training program. Now listen, I prefer traders that know nothing. I prefer individuals that know nothing because when they come to me knowing nothing, they don't have bad habits, they don't have these preconceived notions, they don't have these false ideas, erroneous beliefs. They come to me with a blank slate and I'm able to sort of paint my masterpiece with them. So I don't want anyone who has very little or no experience at trading to be worried about that. That in my book is actually a plus. It is not a negative. It is a plus. Now, after teaching each individual all of the trading tactics, the concepts, the money management techniques, the trade management techniques, how to take their profits, when to take their profits, all of the techniques. After being taught that, each trader must work their way through this grid. Now, each trader, after that training, has to take a $50,000 account. $50,000. This is a practice account first at level one. They have to take a $50,000 practice account and demonstrate their ability to make $3,000 with those techniques and tactics. Once that trader has demonstrated his ability to make $3,000, that trader has fully graduated my training program. So the training is two parts. First, the trader learns the techniques and the tactics. I'm going to teach you some of those techniques and tactics today. Once they understand those tactics, they take a $50,000 practice account, $50,000. They go into the markets and demonstrate their ability to make $3,000. Now, they don't have to make $3,000 in a day or a month or a week. They just have to ultimately make $3,000. It can be $5 a day. They can make $100 this day, $50 another day, $600 another day. And once they accumulate $3,000 in gains, they've fully graduated. Now, once they've graduated, this $50,000 account is real. That is my capital. No trader of mine ever risks a single penny of their own money. 100% of the risk is mine. The trader never puts a single penny of his or her family's money at risk at this. I believe traders are better when they use my capital, not their capital. This is a hidden secret on Wall Street. No professional trader uses his own capital. No professional trader puts his own money in. And for that matter, most successful businesses don't use their own capital either. And this is a business. Okay? So listen, once they make this $3,000, they fully graduated. The account is now live. And then their goal, once again, is to make $3,000. They get 40% of all the gains. And of course, I get 60%. It's a business. But remember, my money is at risk, not the trader. The trader's money is not at risk. Once they make this $3,000, I then give them access to $100,000. Now at level two, their goal is to go for a $6,000 gain. They get 40% of all profits. I get 60% of all profits. Once they pass the $6,000 level, I then give them access to $250,000, $250,000. Then their goal is $10,000. Once again, they get 40% of all gains. I get 60% of all gains. Then at level four, they get $500,000, access to $500,000 account. And their goal is 20. Now there are more levels. There's five, there's six, there's seven. You get the point. This is just to explain how the trader systematically works their way into bigger and bigger accounts. Now, this is exactly how Wall Street trading firms are set up. I was one of the top Wall Street traders for an 8-year period. I had a grid like this to work through. I worked myself all the way up to an $80 million trading account, but I had certain goals that I had to achieve before gaining access to larger amounts of the firm's capital. When I left Wall Street in September of 1994 to start my own firm, right? I duplicated exactly how things were done in major Wall Street firms. And it has been my dream since September of 1994 to bring professional Wall Street style trading to Main Street, to regular individuals who have historically not had access to this. Historically, traders, regular individuals have not had access because of a lack of capital. I have the capital and a lack of training. I'm one of the most recognized traders in the world. Who better to train you than me? So I provide the training for all traders. I provide the technology for all traders to do the trading with. And I provide the capital. All the individual needs is passion and desire. They can potentially do this. Now, let me explain something a little bit more in detail about this grid. It is not very difficult to take a $50,000 account and make $3,000. That's not the hard part. There are traders who actually make $3,000 in a day with $50,000. I've seen traders make $1,800 in a day. I've seen traders make $1,500 in an hour. Right? So the $3,000 goal is not the hard part, but you know what makes it challenging? That you have to make the $3,000 without losing more than $300 on any given day. Now that's the trick, traders. You've got to make the $3,000 without ever allowing your account to go below a loss of $3,000, or you can't lose more than $300 on any given day. You also can't lose more than $600 on any given week. So there are loss limits, and this is what makes it challenging. You have to make that $3,000 responsibly. You can't make it like a wild casino gambling individual. All right? You can't take the account and be irresponsible. You can't take the account and just lose large amounts of money. You have to make the $3,000 professionally. You have to make the $3,000 responsibly. You've got to make the $3,000 without ever allowing the account to drop below $300 on any given day and $600 on any given week. So as you're progressing toward that $3,000 goal, you have to watch the downside. You have to protect the downside. And this system is what gradually trains a trader how to trade responsibly, how not to gamble. The gambler has big wins and big losses. The professional has moderate wins, small losses. Moderate wins, small losses. It's a professional approach. It's not a gambling approach. I do not want to give my capital to gamblers. I want to give my capital, access to my capital, to responsible traders that know the most important thing is not the profit. The most important thing is not allowing yourself to experience a big loss. Now get this, traders, get this, get this. If on any given day, a trader's account goes negative by $301, they've got 6 seconds. 6 seconds to liquidate everything they have in the account. 6 seconds to get out. 6 seconds to close everything down. And if they do not do the right thing within those 6 seconds, I have algorithms that will instantly auto-close the account in the blink of an eye, and their keyboard will not work until the very next day. That's right. I'm generous by offering my capital to the trader to trade, but I'm not stupid. So there's that 6 second window that every trader has. And if they don't do the right thing, my robots come to the rescue and automatically sell out every single thing in the account without any human intervention. And the keyboard stops working until the very next day. The same thing. If at any point in the week, the account is negative by $600 or more, $601, the trader has 6 seconds. 6 seconds to do the right thing. You want to try never to have my robots come save you. That is not a good look. That is not a good sign that you're doing the right thing. All right? So your goal is to work your way through these levels to gain larger and larger amounts to trade, because the more you have to trade, the more profits you potentially can make for yourselves. Now remember, there is zero risk to the trader. Never will a trader ever have to put his own money in. Never. And if that trader loses my money, I am going to kill him. No, I'm only teasing. If any trader loses my capital, it's my loss. I take it as my fault. I take it as my loss, my inability to train the trader properly. I take 100% of all losses, my capital and my loss, but I share the gains. And that's the key. Now that you understand what I put each one of my traders through, okay? I want to talk to you about, I don't know why I can't, give me just a second here. I want to talk to you about the fact that traders, I'm going to teach you some tactics and some techniques that are going to seem and appear very simple, because they are, but they're also very powerful. But there's usually, when I teach a trader these tactics, there's usually this idea that, Oliver, this is so simple, anyone should do this, and it's not. Anyone can do this, and it's not true. In fact, this industry has a very high failure rate. It is my responsibility to tell you that. This industry has a 92% failure rate, traders. 92%. Trading has a 92% failure rate. Listen to me carefully. I'm going to say it again. Trading has a 92% failure rate. Something I need you to understand. You're just going to have to ask yourself whether you think you have what it takes to be the 8%. Now, in all reality, all business has a high failure rate. Restaurants have like a 96% failure rate. Becoming a professional athlete has a 99.9% failure rate. Okay, business overall has a 90% failure rate. Most businesses don't last more than 5 years, and that's all over the world. So business in general, and trading as a business, has a high failure rate. Let's just get that out of the way. But I want you to be aware of this. I want you to be aware that it's simple, but not easy. I want you to be aware that it doesn't come right away. You have to work at it. Using the tools and tactics and techniques that I'm going to teach you, you have to work at this. Like anything else, you have to practice at it. You have to work at it. You have to build your capacity and your ability over time. It doesn't overnight. Nothing comes overnight. And listen to me, if you can show me something that comes very easily and very quickly, you show me something that you can get very good at right away, I will show you something that you can't get paid for. You see, you get paid for what is difficult. You don't get paid for what everyone else can do. You get paid by becoming good at something that the vast majority of people can't do well. If everyone can do it well, there's no pay for it. Almost everyone in the world can walk. Can you get paid for walking? No. You can't get paid for that, because that's no big deal to people. Oh, yes, I can walk. I can put my right foot in front of my left foot. Please pay me for that. No, practically everyone can do that. No, you get paid for becoming good at something that the vast majority of people can't. Trading is one of those. You happen to become one of the 8%. Oh my God, you understand. This industry, this business, in my opinion, is one of the last businesses that offer 100% total unadulterated freedom and financial independence with just a laptop computer, right? And an internet connection. You are in business from anywhere in the world that you want, from your living room, from a hotel balcony overlooking a beach, from a mountaintop, some private island, from an airplane that has Wi-Fi. You're not stuck to a location. You don't have to, and your only expenses are your data fees. We can talk about. This is the last bastion of total independence. Doctors are not free. They're not independent. You think doctors today, during today's pandemic, really want to be pulled away from their families to go to the hospital? Not today, they don't. Not during this pandemic. But they're not free. They have to. Lawyers aren't free. They're basically slaves to their clients. This is freedom. Trading is freedom. No one tells you when to trade, how to trade, where to trade. All you. This is your business. But have to understand that it's simple, but not easy. there is a 92% failure rate. Once again, you have to ask yourself, after we talk about some things, ask yourself whether you believe you have what it takes. Put the time in, I'm the 8%. Okay? So let's talk about some tools here, traders. Let's talk about some tools. Now, these are the tools that we need to start trading. I'm going to primarily talk about one approach that I typically start traders off with. But the five things we need are as follows. We need a 2-minute chart. We need a chart of a stock that divides the stock's action into 2-minute pieces. So every bar on the chart represents 2 minutes in time. I'll show you that. We need a simple 20-period moving average overlaid on that chart and a 200-period moving average overlaid on that chart. I'm going to teach you what the picture of power is so that you know how to identify that. And then we're going to zero in on a very small risk trading tactic. We're going to put all five of these things together, and I'm going to show you how you can take these five things and go into the markets and consistently pull money out. Now, here is a 2-minute chart. This is a 2-minute chart of Facebook, to be more specific. Now, each bar represents 2 full minutes of trading. The red bars indicate bars that have started at the high of the bar and fell, dropped, boom, 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 boom. So every red bar starts and then drops lower than the start. All right, I want you to understand that. Red bar starts and drops lower than where it started. Red bar starts and drops lower than where it started. The green ones are just the opposite. The green bar starts and ends the 2-minute period higher than where it started. The green bar starts and ends the 2-minute period higher than where it started. Now take a look at this bar. This bar, this green bar started here, went all the way up to here at one point, and then fell back some. See how it fell back some? Back some. Not all the way to the start, but it lost about half of its green. All right? This was green, and it lost about just a little bit more than half of the green that it had during that 2-minute period. So this is a 2-minute chart. Okay? Now, we want to overlay a simple 20-period moving average on this chart, which we'll do next. We're going to take the 20-period moving average and the 200-period moving average and put it on the chart. Boom. Here's another chart, just another example here. Okay? Now, here's a 20-period moving average. The 20-period moving average, the blue one rising, and here's your 200-period moving average. Now, what do moving averages do? Very simple. The 20-period moving average is just averaging the last 20 closing prices and creating a smoother line. It smooths out the stock's data. The 200 is averaging the last 200 2-minute bars and giving you a longer view of the stock's overall trend. So this is the shorter view. The 20-period moving average is giving you the shorter-term view of the trend, and the 200 is giving you the longer-term view of the trend. All right? Now, I tell my traders, you should never, ever look at a chart for the rest of your life again without these two moving averages. Guys, these are the two major moving averages. I don't care whether you're looking at stocks, options, bonds, futures, cryptocurrencies. I don't care what chart it is. Every single chart should have a simple 20-period moving average on it and a 200. These are anchored to the price. All right? Very important. Now, I want to talk to you about what the picture of power is. The blue line is the 20-period moving average. The red line is the 200-period moving average. Now, what do I call the picture of power up? It is when your stock is rising above the 20-period moving average. And the 20-period moving average is rising above the 200. So you have three items: stock rising above the 20, 20 rising above the 200. So it's sort of like this three-finger spread. One finger, two fingers, three fingers. Now, the 200 does not have to be rising. The only things you want rising really are, once again, the stock should be rising, the 20-period moving average should be rising, and both of those things should be above the 200, which does not have to be rising. All right, that's the picture of power up. It's very important to understand. Now, let's take a look at an example. This is a company called Beyond Meat, okay? They make fake meat, basically. But again, we're looking at a two-minute chart. Every bar represents 2 minutes of trading. The green ones, that means that the stock during that two-minute period of time rose. The red ones, the stocks during that two-minute time dropped. Okay, now, take a look at the 20-period moving average. Note that your stock is rising, your 20-period moving average is rising, and both are above the 200-period moving average. This is the picture of power up. There is also a picture of power down, which is the reverse picture. But let's just talk about the picture of power up. When you have a stock that is displaying the picture of power pointing up, the game becomes simple. When you have the picture of power up, I want you to play the color game. Now, what is the color game? It's simple. The color game is whenever you get a red bar, you mark the high of the red bar off. Mark the high of the red bar off. And when a green bar pokes above the high of the red bar, boom, you come into the play. Whenever a green bar pokes its head, trades one penny above the high of the red bar, boom, you come into the play. 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 Very, very simple. Very simple. Rising stock, rising 20, both over the 200, start the color game. Now, a few things here. Not every single time green takes out red do I want you getting in. I want you getting into the ones that are actually relatively close to the 20-period moving average. I don't want you playing up here and the 20-period moving average is there. You want to play near the 20-period moving average, near the 20-period moving average, okay? Near the 20-period moving average. Your best opportunities are going to come when you are relatively close to your moving average. This is not that far, actually. I just don't want you playing out here So when your stock runs out here, that's not a time to be buying. You want to buy when your stock is relatively near the 20-period moving average. Now, when your stock moves away from the 20-period moving average, that's when you're looking to sell. When your stock moves away from the 20-period moving average, that's when you're looking to sell. So your entries are color game near the 20-period moving average, profit away from the 20-period moving average. Color game near the 20-period moving average, profit away from the 20-period moving average. Now listen to me carefully. This is probably going to be one of the most important things I reveal to you today. Over 80% of all losses in the market are because of one thing. Over 80% of all losses are the result of trading against the 20-period moving average. I'll repeat this again. 80% of all losses are the result of trading against the 20-period moving average. So when the 20-period moving average is up, the trader is betting down. Wrong. When the 20-period moving average is rising, they want to bet down. So when red happens, they bet down. That's wrong. When the 20-period moving average is rising, you want to ignore reds. You're not concerned with reds when the 20-period moving average is rising. You're not concerned with down bars. That's likely to be temporary. Red is meaningless when your 20-period moving average is rising, but the novice, untrained traders allow red bars to trick them into thinking that there's trouble, into thinking that the stock should drop because of a red bar, not when the 20-period moving average is rising most of the time. Very, very important. When your 20-period moving average is rising, you bet to the upside. You buy. You do not bet to the downside. When the 20-period moving average is declining, you bet to the downside. You do not bet to the upside. You trade with the 20-period moving average. You trade with the 20-period moving average. You trade with the 20-period moving average. Two more times, please. You trade with the 20-period moving average. You trade with the 20-period moving average. Rule number two. You enter near the 20-period moving average, not away from it. You enter near the 20-period moving average, not away from it. Now, every single play is not going to work, as you know. I'll teach you how to protect yourself on the plays that don't work. Nothing's 100%. Many plays will work. Some will not, and you'll have to know how to handle yourself on the ones that don't, and we're going to cover that. Now, here is the picture of power down. This is the reverse. In this picture of power, you have your stock is declining under a declining 20-period moving average, and both are under the 200-period moving average. One, stock moving down under the 20 moving down under the 200. That's your three-finger spread again. Now, in this picture, you're going to bet down. You're going to play the color game down. Now, let's take a look at the color game down. All right? Now, take a look at Facebook. Two-minute chart. Every bar represents 2 minutes of trading. I want you to take a look at the stock. Trend is down. It is under a declining 20-period moving average, and both are under the 200. Once you have the picture of power down, the game becomes simple. It's the color game in reverse. We're betting to the downside. Yes, in our game called trading, we can make money when the stock goes up, and we can also make money if the stock goes down. That's called shorting. All right? So when do we enter short? When green occurs, we mark off the, when a green bar occurs, we mark off the low. When red breaks below the low of a green bar, we come from way over here. Boom! Right there is your entry. You want to make sure that you're playing the color game near the 20-period moving average, not away from the 20-period moving average. Near the 20-period moving average. Look at your moments near. Green bar, break the low. Boom! We're near the 20-period moving average. Green bar, it doesn't have to be touching the 20, just not far away from it. Doesn't have to touch it. That's fine. This is close enough. Green bar, mark the low. Boom! There's your entry. Now, remember, you want to come into the play near the 20. You want to come out of the play away from the 20. All right? You want to come in near the 20 and come out away from the 20. So away is profit-taking time. Near is entry time. Away is profit taking time. Near is entry time. Very simple but powerful. Now, I want to explain the next concept, which is also just as important. I want you to take a look at the left-hand side of the chart. I want you to look at all three items. I want you to look at the stock, Facebook. I want you to look at the stock. That's Facebook. I want you to look at the 20-period moving average, and I want you to look at the 20-period moving average. Now, look at how close they are together. They're very tight together. See? Very tight. That's what I call a narrow state. All three items are clustered together in a narrow state. Now, I want you to go to the sort of right-hand side of the chart. Now look at your stock, the 20, and the 200. This is a wide state. Narrow state, wide state. Narrow state, wide state. When your stock goes to wide, the color game stops. Listen to me carefully, traders. You play the color game from narrow to wide. Once your stock has achieved a wide state, no more color game. No more color game. The game is over. Because once you go wide, the market is ready to reverse to go right back to narrow again. You see, look, markets do nothing more than vacillate between two states. This is how it looks. They go narrow to wide. From wide, back to narrow. From narrow, back to wide. And from wide, back to narrow. It's almost like inhaling. During the narrow state, the market is inhale. And during the expansion state, exhale. Inhale. Exhale. All right? Then back to inhale. Then exhale. Now, listen, here's what's interesting. If you're in a narrow state, you don't know whether the exhale is going to be up or whether it's going to be down. In this case, from the narrow state, Facebook moves out of the narrow state down, but it could have moved out of it up. But you don't have to know that in advance. Just wait. When does the narrow state broken? Right here. Boom! Now you know from Facebook's narrow state, we're going down to a wide state. Now let me get my color game ready. All right? Green takes out, red takes out, green, boom! Red takes out, green, boom! Red takes out, green, boom! You know the deal. When do you profit take? Away from the moving average. When you get in, near, doesn't have to touch. When do you get out? Away from the moving average. Wide state, game over. Now, guys, I want you to understand this. From this point to, let's say, here, if you put in 200 shares, that's two lots. Every lot is 100 shares. The smallest you can put in is 100 shares. Then the next biggest is 2. Then the next biggest is 300. And in my program, you can go at level one, you can go all the way up to 500 shares. So if we just took the second smallest, 200 here, all right? About 119, 191, 190. Okay. That is $400. That's a $400 drop from here. Look, $400, 200 shares in, boom. To here, away. $400. But now count the minutes. Every bar is 2 minutes. 2 minutes, 4 minutes, 6 minutes, 8 minutes. Let's say 8.5 minutes. 8 to 10 minutes, $400 with only 200 shares. What if you had put 500 shares in? The whole thing. 8 minutes, 2, 4, 6, 8, and yet that last, that's 10. 8 to 10 minutes, you got $1,000. But what if you also took this one and added it to this game? Now it's your next trade. Boom! This move to here, a little bit less. But if you did the whole 500 shares, maybe this is closer to $800. Two plays, one, two, $1,800 at the highest level. Let's say you did it with just the 100 shares because you're a nervous trader. You do 100 shares. All right. Well, at this point, you have $200 in 8 minutes. That's dollars. 8 minutes. What business can you do this in? 100 shares here. Out here, it is like $180. Two plays. Boom. Done. Finish. Go to the park. Go to the beach. But what if these trades don't work? What do? Your entry is one penny under that green bar. Boom! Right there. Your stop is here. Your protection is always above the opposite color bar. So we're playing the red bar. Our stop is above the green one. So if this stock turns around, boom, we get out. Now listen, guys. The most important act is this one. This is how I judge whether you're a professional or not. I don't judge whether you're a professional if you get in here and get out there. You didn't really do anything but pray, right? The stock did this. But you have to do something at the stop. That's where I judge you. Do you stop out properly? Do you protect my capital? Do you protect my account? Do you kill the trade when you're supposed to kill the trade? Are you responsible? Do you prevent my account, our capital, because it's our capital. It's my capital, but you're trading it, so it's like it's ours. Are you disciplined enough to kill the trades when they don't work? Are you disciplined enough to keep your account less than that $300 daily loss? Are you disciplined enough to end the game when it's supposed to be ended? And that's how I judge your level of professionalism, not by your gains. I judge your professionalism by your losses. How does this trader lose? Is this trader a good loser? Is this trader a small loser? Does this trader get out at the right time without question, without hesitating? That's professional. On this play, under the green, you get in here, boom, your stop is here. Now get this. This is cool. Get this, guys. So here is what I call, this is what we call your risk unit. That's your risk right there. It's pennies. But look at the potential gain you had. You see that? This is your risk. When you lose small. But when you win, oh my God. We call this the snowman approach. This is your risk, right? That's your risk. And this is your profits. That's your snowman, right? You get the point. You want this to be profits and this to be losses. You want this to be profits and this to be losses. If you can do this, I promise you, you will gain the ability to make more money faster than the vast majority of people in the world. Your average trade will last 8 to 12 minutes. That's crazy. 8 to 12 minutes is your average trade. This was an 8 to 10 minute trade. What is this one? This one, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, a little bit longer. It's actually 8 to 16. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. All right, a little bit longer. Sometimes they're a little bit longer. But this one took a little bit longer to take. But there's something interesting here. There's the red takeout green. Protect yourself. But look at the potential gain. You see the potential gain? There's the snowman again. As long as you can ensure that your risk unit is small, I promise you, traders, this is the most important aspect of it. You'll be able to do this. Keep that risk unit small. And you're going to get winners that are way bigger than your risk unit. The problem is risk units, if your game is opposite, where this is your risk unit and this is your gain, this is a losing trader. Because they lose here, but they only win. So here's the entry. They lose up here, boom, loss, but they only win here. This is a losing trader. This is the winning trader. Risk unit little, profit bigger. Risk unit little, profit bigger. All right. Now, although this is beyond the scope of this talk that I'm going to have with you today, once your market goes wide, right, I teach my traders to play the other way. So we were playing down here, but once you go wide, you play the color game backwards now, back to the upside, right? So now, look, when red gets eliminated, boom. When red gets eliminated, boom. But these are some larger risk units. So I want you to focus on those smaller risk units. Okay? That's how you have to start this game, with the smaller risk units. Let's talk about some rules here. All right? Here are the rules. Very important, traders. Very important rule. This is where we begin, actually. Now listen to me carefully. Listen to me carefully. I need you to look at my face here. All right? I need you to look at my face here. Traders, listen to me carefully. What I'm going to show you now can change your life. I'm telling you, I have changed the lives of hundreds of traders throughout this world, teaching them and giving them the ability to basically pull money out of the markets almost on a daily basis. Almost, not impossible, not possible daily, but almost. Some have gone on to be huge in the industry. Hundreds have changed their lives with what I'm about to show you, teach you. This can change life. Now, I want you to understand, I want to put you in this business. This is your business, but I want to put you in the business. I want to fund your business, your trading business. This is your trading business. I want to fund that trading business. You keep your family's money safe. We use my money just in case it doesn't work, right? I fund the business. You do what I'm about to teach you and show you. And if you do it correctly by keeping that risk unit small and getting out when you're supposed to get out, I promise you, you can change your life with this. There's no excuse, because you will have the right training from me. You will have all the capital you ever need to do this. Bigger and bigger, bigger. No one will tell you when to trade. You trade when you want to. No one will tell you how long to trade. It's your business. Most of my traders trade 30 minutes and they're done. Some traders are done in the first 8 to 10 minutes of the day. Some traders like to trade all day long. That's up to them. It's their business. No one tells you where to trade from, when, how often. I've got some traders that trade twice a week because they work. This is an amazing business, but you've got to do it correctly. What are the things that I told you are the correct things? We're going to cover some of those rules now. Trading with the 20-period moving average. 20-period moving average is up. We play the color game up. 20-period moving average is down. We play the color game down. When the moving averages go wide, the game is over. If you want to, you can play the color game backwards now, back to the upside or back to the downside if they're wide. Now, your best trades will come from a narrow state, right? Your best moves will come from when all three of those things are tight and narrow. When wide, the game is over. If you want, you play the opposite game. All right, now, everything I've covered up to this point was foundation. Now we get into some detail. This is what you're going to have to do on a day-by-day basis. All right? Let's get back to these rules. There are five rules. Follow these five rules. You can do this. You can do this. Some of you might be asking, Oliver, why do you do this? If you're such a big trader, why do you do this? Why do you sell courses? I don't sell courses. Stop saying that. I don't sell courses. I wish I could shout this from every rooftop in the world. I don't sell courses. I open trading businesses. This is not a course. This is a business. Now, why do I set traders up in business? Why do I go around the world setting traders up for business? It's very simple. Money. Listen, I can't be in every stock at the same time. So when I'm playing the color game in Facebook, what about the color game in Microsoft going on right now? What about the color game in Apple going on right now? I'm playing the one in Facebook, but I'm missing the one in Microsoft. I'm missing the one going on in Apple. I'm missing the one going on in Twitter. But I want it all. Do you understand? I guess I'm greedy that way. So I want to grow my trading team so that I say, okay, look, I've got Facebook, you've got Twitter, you've got Microsoft, you've got Apple, and we miss nothing. Tell me you understand this, traders. This is business. It's powerful. I don't want a single opportunity to go by without us collect, some of us at least there to take advantage of it. And I get 60%. And you get 40%. So I might say to a trader, look, you've got these three stocks. Don't miss an opportunity in these three. You've got these three. You've got these five. You've got the whatever. And spread my team out over the entire market. Every single color game entry, boom! I want my money into that because I single-handedly can't do that. This is not about courses. I want you to understand it. I do not sell courses. I am expanding business. I am recruiting traders. I am putting traders in business. That is what I do. Okay, just wanted to make that clear. I hate that. I hate it.
Oliver, why do you sell courses?
I don't sell courses. Put traders in business. See, I'm all stressed out now. Okay, let's go. Let's go. All right. Five trading rules. Guys, follow these five rules. Promise you, you'll be able to do this. Follow these five rules and you will be the 8%. I just can't force you to do it. All I can do is train you to do it, but I can't force you to do it. You'd be surprised how many traders just refuse to do it. It baffles me. Five simple rules. Trade with the 20 period moving average. We discussed that. If the 20 period moving average is rising, please bet to the upside. Buy. Don't try to get fancy and find the top. Try to find the top when it starts going down. No. If the 20 period moving average is declining, bet down. Play the color game down. Stop fighting the 20 period moving average. Please, please promise me, please stop it. All right, rule number two. Your best buys are going to be above the 200. So if the 200 is here, you want your buys to be above, not below the 200. Now, there are exceptions. Remember I said when a stock goes from narrow to wide, you want to bet down here. But when wide, you can break this rule and now play up the color game. But only from wide. Wide cancels out this rule. But if you're not wide, you want to trade with the 20. All right. Above the 200. Not below it. Okay. You want to short below it. See, when you're below it, you want your 20 declining. Here's your 200. Here's your 20. Right? Now you want to make sure you bet down. And your bet is under the 200. You don't want to be betting down above the 200. Very simple rules, but powerful. All entries near the 20, not away from the 20. We take profits away from the 20. We don't get in away from the 20. We get out away from the 20. So all entries are near. We profit away from the 20. All right? So look, here's your 20 period moving average. Let's do that blue. All right? Here's your 20 period moving average. Here's your 200. Here's your stock. Now your stock comes near the 20. Color game. Boom. Entry. All right, away, profit take. All right, you come back, color game entry, away, profit take. Simple. Small risk units. Remember, your risk units are small and your profits are bigger. Risk units, small, profit bigger. That's the key to success in this game. I'm telling you the secret. This is the success formula. Trade with the 20, buy above the 200, short below the 200, all entries near the 20, profit take away, repeat, 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 repeat. This is the secret formula. It's simple, but it's not easy. I'm not going to tell you that it's easy. It's simple, but it's not easy.
Right.
You know there's a difference. Now, we're going to take the $50,000 I'm going to give you, and I'm going to teach you how to use this $50,000 to change your life. It's still kind of small, but you have to start there, and you work your way up. But we're going to start with $50,000, traders. Here's a tactic. This is the color game, and we call this the red bar ignored. The name is not important. I just have to teach you how to play this. Let's assume that your 20 period moving average is rising. Right? Here's your 200. Once you get that color game entry, red bar, mark the high off, you're going to take, once green takes out the high of the red bar. Now, guys, listen, this is important. You're not waiting for this bar to finish. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. You're coming in here. Boom. The moment, the second, the nanosecond, green pops above the high of that red. That green bar is still moving. It has not finished. So what? boom, get inside of that green bar right above the high of that red bar. Now, your protective stop is here, right under the red bar. This is your risk unit right there. We are hoping for the gain move away from the moving average to be bigger than the risk unit. Right. Nice. Now, that's the technique. That's the strategy. It's simple. Powerful, too. Here's the thing. I want you, out of the $50,000, I want you to take $25,000. And you put that this $25,000, put it, boom, right into the stock there and protect yourself. $25,000, half of the account. You will reserve the other $25,000 for additional color game plays. Because there are times when you get another one, right? Like this. Other one. Not too far from the 20. And boom, right there. Let me do it. Right there. Boom. That's where you take another part. Maybe you want to now, instead of, you can put the next 25,000 in here if you want, or you can break it up if you like. Boom! I don't want you going in with everything at first. My recommendation is that you cut your account in half. Put 25,000 in for the first one. If you get another one, put maybe 12 or 13,000 in, and then another one, the remainder. And this will ensure that when you do lose on the plays that lose, you're not losing with the whole 50,000. You're losing only on half of it. This will help keep your losses small. But it's time to play this game in the big leagues. You can't do this with $2,000. You can't do this with $5,000. You can't do this with $10,000, traders. That is not professional. You've got to at least have $50,000 to do this right, and even that small. But you have the ability to work up to bigger numbers. Now, with the $50,000 account, with traders that live in certain parts of the world, they can earn their whole living with a $50,000 account. Because a $50,000 account, you can have $600 days, $800 days, $300 days, $100 days, $400 days. You understand? So some traders, if you live in New York City, that's not going to cut it for you. You have to work yourself up to higher levels. But in many countries throughout the world, a trader can earn their whole life, their whole living at the first level. Crazy. Best business in the world. The best business in the world. And the perfect business for this time, this pandemic laden time. Boom! $25,000 in. Protect yourself under that red bar. That's your most important act, the protection. Boom! Put that $25,000 in above that red bar. Look at your rising 20. Look at your stock is above the 20. The 20 is rising. The 20 is above the 200. Red bar, mark off the high. Green bar trades one penny above the red bar. Boom, 25,000 in. But listen, I always tell traders to come from way over here. Send that $25,000 missile. Don't come from here. Boom. No. We're going to come from way over here. Boom. $25,000 in. Protect yourself. Protect yourself. Small risk unit. That's your key. Small risk unit. That's your key. All right. Sometimes it's two reds in a row. That's fine. Boom. Protect yourself. Small risk unit. That's your key. Microsoft. Now, I've only been with you for a little over an hour, and I'm willing to bet that the vast majority of people who, even if you didn't know anything about trading in the markets, you can take this two-minute chart of Microsoft and tell me exactly where the entries are. Do it now. Do it. You can do it. You can do it. You see them? Do you see where the stock moves away from the 20 period moving average? That's where you want to take profits. So let's go over these. Real lifetime chart, real chart of Microsoft. All right. Look at the 20 period moving average rising. It is above the 200. Okay. Now remember, what are the rules? Trade with the 20. Buy above the 200. We're above the 200. Enter near the 200. All right? Take profits away from the 200. Those are simple rules, right? Okay. So we got 20 rising. We're gonna buy. We're above the 200. We're going to buy, and we're going to look for entries near the 20-period moving average. Color game near. Look at the red bar. Red bar. Mark off the high. Boom! All right. Red bar. Here's another one. Red bar. Mark off the high. Boom! Protect yourself. Don't forget that protection. You're buying above the high of this red. Where is your protection? Below the red. You're buying above this red. Boom! Where's your protection? Below the red. Look at this red. Look at the high. Mark off the high. When does the high get broken? Boom! If you've got more missiles, send them in. Wait. Look, you see this red? This red's hiding from you. It's a little red. Mark off that red. Boom! Wait a minute. See this red here? Mark off that red's high. Profit take away from the 20 period moving average. Guys, this is not rocket science. You can do this. Do you have any notion how much money this is in a short period of time? Wow. You see how we went from wide, see the items wide apart? Stock, 20. We won't go from wide back to narrow. But now we're narrow. But we keep going back to wide again. So here's the narrow state, all three things together. Here's the wide state. We go from wide to narrow. We keep going to go wide this way. And now this is why your game stops now. You see how sloppy it gets after being wide? Wide means go to the beach. Wide means go, I don't know, walk around the corner, take your dogs out, go to the park, watch your favorite television program, turn on Netflix. Wide means game is over. You can do this, traders. I'm telling you, you can do this. Some of you might be asking, well, Oliver, man, if it's this simple, why is it a 92% failure rate? Oh, that's very simple. They don't follow those five rules I told you. And there's one other thing losing traders don't do. They don't get out under the red. They hope. And this is a problem. I got to talk to you in your faces. I got to do this in your face, guys. I get so bewildered sometimes as to why traders just won't get out. I don't want this to be you. Every trade's not going to be a winner. You have to get out under that red bar. Keep that risk unit small. This and fighting the 20 period moving average and not getting out, 92% fail because of those two things. They fight the 20 period moving average. One. Two, they don't get out under the red bar. If I can just get you to do those two things, my God, you'll be on your way. You have to almost be proud of being an excellent loss taker. You want to be proud of that. You want to show me, Oliver, look at my losses. That's the attitude. Look at how professional I lose, Oliver. That makes me proud. You see, winners happen without you. You buy a stock at 20 and it goes to 21. What did you do? You prayed. I mean, prayer is powerful, but you didn't push the stock up. You didn't call up your billionaire friends and say, listen, I just bought Microsoft here. Can you put a few billion dollars into Microsoft and make it go up, please? You didn't do that. You freaking prayed. The stock did that. So the stock's responsibility is to make money for you. It's a partnership. The stock's responsibility is to make money from you, for you. You understand? Your responsibility is to get out when you're supposed to get out. Stock's responsibility is to go up, not your responsibility. That stock does not do its job. Boom. You get out. You fire it. You cut its head off. You understand this? If you can't be a... If you're not good at that, you're going to be 92%, right? The 8% they cut, zero tolerance. Then you know what the 8%, you know what their attitude is? When they get into a stock, boom, they get in, right? Their attitude is, okay, now, Microsoft, you got this amount of room, all right? You got this amount of room. Go do your job. If you don't do your job, I am going to kill you. Right here. Here's the line. Now go. That's the attitude of a master trader. A master trader hires a stock to do a job. Go make me money. You've got this amount of space. Fail, I will kill you. You can get that part of the game right. You can be the 8%. So what are the two main things that cause the 92%? Failure to cut when the play should be cut. They hope that it comes back. They hope they get their money back. They hope the situation improves. They hope all the way to the poorhouse. Hope has no place in this game. Do you understand? Zero tolerance. Zero. That's one reason why there's a 92%. The other reason is fighting the 20 period moving average, which is another way of saying fighting the trend. They don't go with the flow. They don't go with the power. They try to get cute and fancy. They think they're too smart, and they think that I know when this is going to end. No, play with the 20 period moving average. Play with the 20 period moving average. They also get in at the wrong time. They get in after the stock has gone up, away from the 20. That's when you should be getting out. So all of these are the reasons for the 92%. I just have to convince you that if you can follow these five simple rules I laid out for you, you will be the 8%. You will. It's not going to come right away. Nothing comes right away in life. Not something that you can get paid for. But don't be the 92%. Don't. Let's go back. All right. Here's the play on the downside, right, traders? Here's the play on the downside. You're going to come in here, boom! But remember, you need that 20 period moving average. You need that 20 period moving average declining. Woo, beautiful. You need that. You need to be have everything under the 200. So the 20 under the 200 and your stock under the 200. Don't forget, protect yourself. Get in here, 25,000, and boom, protect yourself. This is your risk unit. That's one of the keys to success. A tight, small risk unit, traders. This is your key, one of your keys. It's not the only key, but it's one of them. And we talked about this. You know, we've seen this before. Here's your green bar. Boom. Mark off the low. The moment a red bar breaks the low of green, boom, 25 in. Where's your protection? Above the green, that's your risk unit. Away. Here's your risk unit. Away. Look at how you get away. All right? Wide. Now the game this way has to be over. Slightly more advanced is to play opposite now, but that's a different talk. All right, that's a different talk. There it is. All right, look at this, traders. Oh my God. Are you kidding me? This is a company called Cisco, but look at this. Look at your tight, narrow. You see the tight, narrow state I told you about? Stock, 20-200, narrow. Your best plays are going to be from a narrow state. Boom, we break down. You could have broken up out of the narrow state, all right? And then the game would be up, right? But no, we break down out of the narrow state, so okay, the game is down. Simple. All right, green bar, boom. When do you break the low of this green bar? Boom. When do you break the low of that little green bar? Look how little that risk is. I love that. Boom. Look at this green bar. Boom! Look at this green bar. Boom! Look at this green bar. When does red break it? Boom! Oh my God. Guys, I have a trading kids team. The team is consists of a little over 300, overall 300 trading kids have gone through the trading kids program. They're ages 10 to 15, right? Right? Ages 10 to 15. I teach them to do this. I've got 10, 11-year-olds making $1,600 in a day, in a morning. $800, $1,000. Some of you may even know some of my trading kids because they're active on social media and show their trading. It's crazy. You can do this. It's not rocket science. It's a few simple principles, a few simple rules to abide by, and the discipline to carry them out. The problem, one other problem in this industry, is that there are far too many traders trading with inadequate amount of capital. Because the smaller your capital, the harder the game is. You've got to have the right amount of capital. Most traders don't have a method or a plan. They're just gambling. It's a casino to them. They're guessing. I don't want you guessing. I want you to have a specific plan. I want you to know where to protect yourself, exactly where to get in. I want you to know when it's time to take profits. These can't be guesses. You have to know. And I teach you. This is just one thing. Imagine if you gave me 2 years of your life. You know where you'd be 2 years? This is 2 hours of your life. And many of you are seeing the markets with clarity after 2 hours. What if you gave me 2 years? You know where you'd be? Wow. If you gave me 5 years to work with you every day, my God, you'd be a superstar. Crazy. I still love it. Look at QCOM. Look at how beautiful this is. My God. Look at this. Look at the 20 period moving up. Look at your stop. Look at the 20. Look at the 200. All right. So we got the picture of power. Now find the red bars near the 20. Look at that red bar. Boom! Protect yourself, risk unit. Now look at the risk unit. Now you move away, right? You move away. You got to take profits away. Now look at the risk unit and look at your profit unit. That's the snowman. Look how little that is. Now how many of these fit inside of this? That's the key. Now let's go to the next one, all right? You see this red one? When does that red get taken out by green? Right here. Boom. This is your risk unit. Then you have another one. Boom. That's what I said. Look, if you put 25,000 in here, you can put the other 25,000 there. Now you've got all of it in. Now you're going to really, if it works, whoo, you're going to really look at this. Thing, man. Or realistically, I would be taking profits there. That's the move away. It moved even further, but even at that, with this risk unit and that profit, wow. How many of these fit inside of there? You can lose 2-3 times and then win once and still make money as long as your risk unit is small. It's crazy. This is proper trading, guys. It's careful. It's not wild. It's not gambling. It's a concise, a very precise approach. You know exactly when to get in and where, to the penny, nothing vague. You know exactly when. Look, you know exactly when to get in, boom, to the penny. There's nothing questionable. There's no, I get in around here. No. This is the penny I get in. Boom. You know exactly to the penny where to get out if it doesn't work. You know exactly where to get in. You know exactly where to get out if it doesn't work. You know exactly where to add extra if you like. And you know when you move away from that 20, it's time. Away from that 20, it's time. Powerful. You know that when you start to get wide, the game is over. When you get too wide there, the odds start to break down. Very powerful, traders, very powerful. Boom, boom. Here it is to the downside. Look at that 20-period moving average. Look at the narrow state. Close together. Here's the wide, wide state, right? We could come out of the narrow up, but we come out of the narrow down. So now we play down. Green. Now this risk unit is a little bigger, all right? So if the risk unit is bigger, you don't want to do 500. Remember, you have 100, 200, 300, 400, and 500. If your risk unit is little, you can do like a 400, right? If your risk unit is small, you might want to do a 1 or 200. I mean, if it's bigger, see, this is a bigger risk unit. So you probably want to do something like this one. If this risk, on this risk unit, let me show you. On this risk unit, this is smaller. You can probably do like a 3 or 4 on that one. Away, away. Everything is based on risk. Powerful. Traders, powerful. Now that's insane. So guys, I don't want you to think that I'm cherry picking the best examples. No, I'm not. There are so many plays that you will never have enough money to take all the plays. That's why I do this. I can't take all the plays that are happening. I can't be in all the spots, all the stocks. That's why I need you. We do this as a team. And we all make a freaking fortune if we do it the right way. You know what to do. Well, this is an interesting one, guys, because I wanted to reveal to you that, all right? This is interesting because I want to reveal to you that you can, as long as the 20 is rising, you can dip below the 20. That's fine. That's not bad. You can take a buy below as long as you're close to the 20. You can take a buy above as long as you're close to the 20. See, this is this red. The green takes out the red. It's a little below the 20, but that's fine. But look at all your boom. 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 Don't forget, tight risk units. Tight risk units. Tight risk units. Now, there are many other things I need to teach you. This is not the only thing, but this can get you started. This can get you started. Imagine if you have everything that I teach. Wow. Rising 20, 20 over the 200. Now, start your color game. Boom, boom. Risk, small risk unit, small risk unit. Away, profit take. Look at that risk unit. Look at this risk unit compared to the profit move. Wow, how many of these fit inside of here? Many. That's how you stay in business. Notice how we went from wide on the far left. Now look at us narrow. See us narrowing, going back to narrow. Now here we're narrow. From narrow back to wide this way. See? That's all the market does. It vacillates from wide to narrow, narrow back to wide again, wide back to narrow, repeat, repeat, repeat forever. When you understand these principles, how markets operate, and the principles of things like you take profits away. Look, profits away from the 20. Profits away from the 20. Near the 20 you can get in. 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 Profit take away. Profit take away. Profit take away. Woo! Love this game. 38 years, and I still love it like it's the first day. Here's another power run done by NVIDIA. Power runs are crazy. Green. 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 You know what to do. This is boring now. I'm bored. I'm teasing. Another power run. These are power runs. You get these power runs. Guys, I'll give you a bonus here. When a stock starts power running on you, that's when it gives you a lot of little bars, but it just keeps inching into more profits, more profits, more profits. You switch to the 20 period moving average and just relax. Just ride it out. Ride this out. If your first entry was here, boom, and this thing starts power, we call it the power run, right? If it starts power running, flip to the 20 period moving average. Now just relax. Let this thing do whatever it wants to do until it breaks the 20. Boom, that's where you get out. It's these types of things I want to teach you and show you how to maximize your profits. 20 period moving average stop. Boom, right there. Look at that gain. Wow. Wow. All right. You know what to do. You know what to do. We're tight. It's narrow. Look at your 20, your 200 together. All right. Boom. We come out of that tight, narrow state up. Here's, look at this red bar, and look at this red bar. Boom. Okay. Look at your risk unit. Look at the profit move. Crazy. Now, how many of these fit inside of there? Wow. 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 All right, traders. You can do this. You can do this. You know exactly this green bar today, traders. After just spending 2 hours with me, you know that green bar right near that 20 period moving average is an opportunity. You know that if red takes out the low of that green bar, you know today that this is your entry. You know today that this is your stop. You know today that this is your risk unit. You know today that you're going to take profits away from the 20 period moving average. And you know how to repeat that. Repeat, repeat, repeat. Look, green. This bar takes out the low of green. Boom. Stop above. Boom, do it again. Stop above. Play one, play two. I love that sound, by the way. But you love that sound? I love that sound. Love that sound. Look at the 20-period moving average declining. Look at your green bar. Boom. Look at that risk unit. Oh my God. I love those little. Look at this. Look at another. Uh-oh. Oh my God. No. Ooh. Look at this. Look, another green bar. Boom. Look at the risk unit. Look at your profit move. Wow. How many of these fit inside of there? Can do this, traders. You can do this. If you stay away from the two main things that cause most of the losses of the 92%, not cutting, they don't cut. They do not cut. All right? You're serious. You serious? Are you serious? Please. Hello? Wow. Okay. They do not cut, traders. They do not cut. Number two, that they fight with the 20-period moving average. They don't play with it. If you can stay away from those two main things, you can be the 8%. Now, the other thing that causes the 92% is that they're playing with baby money. You can't play this game with baby money. It does not work. You can't show up to a gunfight with a little tiny pocket knife and think you're going to win. It doesn't work that way in real life. That's just dream stuff. That's dreaming. That's not being responsible. You can't do it. You need the right amount of capital. I have the capital for you. You need to be trained, not just for 2 hours, not just for a day, not just for a week. You need to be trained every single day of your life. The training I give to my traders is every day. It's not a course. Remember, I don't sell courses. I sell a lifelong business opportunity. Now, traders, I have to tell you that there is a cost. It costs money to train you. It costs money on my part to have a support team that takes care of you. To have some of the best traders in this business spend time with you every day. I've got to pay them. They won't do it for free. You wouldn't do it for free either. It's going to take time to develop you into a powerful trader. But during that time, there's a cost. And this is a business. All businesses have costs, right? But I promise you this. Your cost to get into the very best business in the world is going to be the lowest cost of any other business opportunity you can ever think of. It's not going to be the cost to open up a restaurant. Do you know how expensive it is to open up a restaurant? Or a shoe store, or a clothing store. The cost to open up this business is very small compared to the cost of all other business opportunities. That's another beautiful thing about it. So I want to talk to you about the business opportunity, right? And I want to tell you that I am aware that this is an opportunity that is not for everyone. This is not for everyone. It may not be for you. That is something you have to decide. But I know that there is a percentage of you listening to me right now where this can be the opportunity of your lifetime. Listen, I will not be doing ever. I will not be offering my capital forever. I can't. All right. There's a certain point where I have enough traders on my team doing this. So this is not a program that is going to last forever. So I want you to understand that. So I know that there's a percentage of you out there. This is going to be one of the best opportunities of your life. I know that. Just like I know this was the best opportunity of my life back in the early 1980s. Okay. So let's talk about the program. Let's talk about the business. I'm going to put you in business. All right. And this is how we're going to do it. Now, the most popular program I have is called the Self-Start Trading Program. I might change that name, but anyway, right now it's called the Self-Start Trading Program, right? In this program, traders, you get, excuse me, in this program, you get 2 days of training that will teach you all of the tactics and techniques. I taught you one today, one. There's a lot of them. All the techniques, the tactics, the indicators we use, the risk management techniques, the trade management techniques, the profit-taking techniques, all of it. 2 days. Once you absorb this, you have access to the $50,000 account. You also have access to daily training every single day via our live trading chat room. So you are with some of the best traders in this industry. They are with you every day, including me, walking you through the market every day, walking you through your trades every day, guiding you, teaching you, developing you, nurturing you every single day, making sure all of your questions are answered. Sometimes you follow their trades, what they're doing. Sometimes they're monitoring your own trades, but you are not alone, ever, never. As long as you have my money in your hands, I am going to make sure you are trained every day of your life. This is not a program that has an expiration date. This is not something that you take. It is not a course. It is a lifelong program. I want you to understand that. Now, what you are paying for is an entry. You're paying to basically be trained. That's my cost. It costs me to train you. And that is what you are paying for. You are not paying for the business. I put the money into the business. That is not what you're paying for. You're paying for training. Now, so you will be trained every single day for the rest of your life as long as you are part of this program. You get the $50,000 account that you can grow to $100,000, $250,000, $300,000, $500,000, and beyond. You get 40% of all the gains. I get 60% of your trading gains. You never have to put money into this. Never, never. Not a single penny. I take all the losses. We share the gains. There is absolutely zero risk in this business to you and your family. Let's talk about cost to get in. There are three different options. I want to start with the middle option here, the $3,000 option. This is two things combined. It's the combo. It's the self-start program, which I just explained to you, and my famous live trading camp. Now, it is in the live trading camp that I take special groups of traders and I give them my 20-minute trading specialty. I want each of my traders to not only know how to trade, but I want them to have what has made me famous in the trading industry, which is my ability to trade, to pull out the biggest amount of money in the markets in the first 20 minutes. Not very many people have that skill and ability. I want my traders to have the ability to trade, to be able to trade 20 minutes a day and be done. They can trade longer than 20 minutes, but they don't have to trade longer than 20 minutes. The live trading camp is the 20-minute trading specialty. That is with me. I take you over 11 weeks. We spend 11 weeks together getting that 20-minute specialty in. So this is overall trading. This is the 20-minute specialty. And let me tell you something. This is, you will never need anything else after these two. There is nothing else to do. No part two, no part three. This is it. Self-start, live trading camp, boom, done for life. Nothing else. Now think about it. You're in this business for one price. You can lose $3,000 in a single trade. You can lose $3,000 in a week, $3,000 in a month, $3,000 in a year. This is forever. One price. Now, what I tell my, I teach my children this the same way my mother taught me this. I want you to think about value, not about cost. I want you to take this $3,000 and break it up over 5 years. Now, listen to me carefully. There's 365 days in a year times five. All right. What does that give us? Think about this, traders. Think about this. This is how you properly regard true cost. So there's 365 days in a year times five. That is 1,800. That's 1,825 days. You should at least dedicate 5 years to this. Imagine where you can be in 5 years. Imagine where you are after 2 hours. Imagine after 5 years where you're going to be. So 1,825 days in 5 years. Now, that's divided by 3,000. That's $1.64 a day. Guys, your coffee is more than that at Starbucks. A candy bar at the bodega or the grocery store is more expensive than that. Some waters, a water is more expensive than $1.64. A soda. The value of this for $1.64 a day. It's crazy. Do you know how much money you can make on a weekly basis and your cost to be a part of this is $1.64 a day? That's mind-boggling. Now, some people may not be able to do the combo all at once. And if you can't, this is where you want to start, the self-start. Now, with just a self-start, you can add the live trading camp later if you can't do it together. Now your cost just went from $3,000 to $1,700. Now that's crazy. Now you take $1,700, your cost is 93 cents a day. 93 cents a day if you're going to dedicate. And guys, when you go into something serious like this, you got to give it at least 5 years. What you can't get a college degree in much less than 5 years today. You can't become a professional athlete without having put 5 years or more into playing it as a kid, playing the sport as a kid or whatever. Give yourself at least that time. Doesn't mean it's going to take 5 years for you to make money. No. You're going to be making money along the way toward that 5-year mark. But the value of what you get every day, training every day, access to capital every day to run your business with just this one cost, 93 cents. Now, if you can't do the self-start, you can start with the live trading camp. It's a little bit less to start that way and then add the self-start later. But you don't have an account with this. So that is why if you can't do the combo, you want to do the self-start first. This comes with the $50,000 account. Access to the funds, access to the capital. Now, I've got something special for you, of course. Just because you're here, you spent this time, we're going to drop the prices until next Friday. You've got these prices right here, right? So not only is the combo not $3,000, now the everything is only $2,000. If you just do the self-start, $1,400. $1,500, let's call it. You've got until Friday. The live trading camp is only $800. But guys, this is for a business, a fully funded business, your business. Now get this. If you commit by Friday, if you commit by next Friday with these prices, I'm going to show you, I'm going to give you 100% of your trading gains until you get your cost back. So what this means is that I will not take my share of the profits until every single dollar you invested is back in your pocket. After you have recouped your cost for the training, that is when I will start to share. So I will stay out of the sharing. You get 100% of all trading gains until this $2,000 is back or this $1,500 is back, whichever one you did. After you get your cost back, after you make this program free, you have the ability to make it free for your trading. After you get your money back, that is when our business together starts. But get this, if you commit by Friday, I'm going to give you the 60%. And I will take the 40%. You are going to be the majority partner in the business. So not only will you get 100% until you get your money back, after you get your money back, you have made this program free through your trading. Congratulations. Now you're going to get 60% of all trading gains. And I will take the smaller 40%. That's my motivational offer to you. But you've got to do it by next Friday. You've got 1 week. 1 week to get it together. 1 week to do it. Traders, this is your opportunity. This is your opportunity to get into one of the best businesses that exist on planet Earth. It could not be a better time during our quarantine, pandemic-oriented life today. The trader life is a quarantine life. Traders not affected by this. This is the very best time to start this. The very best time to do it. I believe in you. Not a program for everyone. Trading is not for everyone. I understand that. But I'm speaking to the people who are touched by this. I'm speaking to the people who are moved by what we did today. This is your time. This is your opportunity. And I believe in you. You can do it. You can be one of the 8% in this business. That will help you get there every single day. Now, I know that, excuse me, traders. I know that there are so many things that you all could be doing right now, but you're here with me. You could be out playing with your kids. You could be out shopping. You could be watching your favorite television. Anything, right? 1,000 different things. But you're here with me. That is something that I do not take for granted. So I want to say thank you for spending your time with me. Thank you for being with me over the last two and a half hours. All right. I want to thank you for giving me your trust. I want to thank you for all. Right? You are a big portion, a big reason. You are my reason for breathing in so many different ways. I love you all. Love you all. I'm going to go back to the slide now, but I want to thank you for just being a part of this. Okay? Let's get some music going. Got to get my music going, my theme song. Boom! Boom! Peace. Uh-oh. I just dropped the prices again. $48, traders. This is until Friday. Now there are really no excuses. 48 hours. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it.